What is up, guys, and welcome to Intel Talking Tech. We have an awesome show and a brand new family member joining us today. I am Justin Rogby, a.k.a. Roby Tech. Welcome to our awesome broadcast. We have a lot packed in for the next 4 hours, but I am joined by two amazing individuals. Well, one amazing individual and myself. And yourself. Yeah, but who are you?
That's what I ask myself every day. But yeah, my name is Alex. I'm a community manager at Intel, and I'm very happy to be here, especially with you and also with Marcus. But Marcus will do his introduction right there.
Yeah, you spoiled it for everybody.
I know. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's why I'm not special.
Thanks, Alex. Yes, I'm Marcus. Yeah, I'm tech evangelist at Intel. I work with Alex, and it's a real pleasure to be here today to share the excitement with you guys and all our partners. I'm super excited. In fact, I'm wearing my excitement on my sleeve and all over, right? This is actually a die to our Core i9. Uses a special die process. And do you guys know why this needs a special die process?
No, I have no idea. I thought that was like a whole body tattoo, but now I'm glad it's just a hoodie, because that would have hurt.
Special die process because of the hyper-threading.
Oh, look at that. hold on a second. So is that like a zip-up hoodie to die for?
It is. This is a pullover hit.
I'm already so proud of you guys.
Thank you.
It starts off right now. You guys are, this is absolutely going to be an awesome show. Now, some people might be here and think, hey, this seems very familiar. And we did something very similar with the launch of 12th Gen here, but it's different this time because we have like a different group of people building and all that sort of stuff. But why are we here? I mean, you're talking about the hyper-threading, but what's the purpose? Like, why are we actually here, Marcus?
We're sharing our excitement, of course, with some of our partners here. We've got Main Gear, Origin, CyberPower, and Zydax. But today you mentioned the new family member. Again, it's the Core i9-12900KS. Last time we were here for the 12th Gen family, we're all here.
Right.
Now, new member, top of the stack, that's a KS processor.
And here you guys, you see the Main Gear over there in the top left. You got Origin hanging out. You've got CyberPower PC and Zydax. They're all getting ready to build systems with these brand new processors. Am I right? Yeah?
That
would have been really lame if I was like, no. That's not it, Roby. No, they're going to be doing 12400F systems.
Exactly.
What?
No. We're going with the KS. Everybody, looking at this, guys, it seems like, I fit right in with the Origin team. So I'll be moving around. I was a little worried that all this light, we have to turn some lights off just because of the glare, but it's going to be good.
Yeah, I did want to say, like, I initially talked about maybe having Turtle Wax sponsor you and Origin at the same time, but they weren't able to basically make that happen, which would have been pretty funny. But what is the KS? Like, again, what does S stand for? I mean, I've gotten that question a couple times, even with our review and everything that's kind of come out this morning as people are starting to get more information on this chip. What does S mean?
Well, first of all, like, I love boring stuff in the automotive world, right? So S always means something a little bit special, a little bit faster,
right?
But Alex?
Yeah, so S means that it is a special edition. So, right? So this is not your run-of-the-mill processor. So there's a little bit something special on it. It is, like we said before, it's the top of the line. It has a couple of new, brand new features that, and these features are enabled by some technology that you're already aware of that we'll actually cover throughout the show. So I don't know, Marcus, will tell us like what are a couple of these things that are new on the KS processor.
Well, first let's start with what makes it special.
Okay.
Okay. Yes. So all new highest end frequency of 5.5 gigahertz, right? And there's other technologies that you mentioned that I'll get into later, but what enables this 5.5 gigahertz max frequency?
KS special, not special. It's special edition, but it's not the KSE. So we didn't name it with like
Do
a place on a keyboard and blah, 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 it's KSE. And this is not like, I think there's something that was important there because I know people are starting to get out in the reviews and they're starting to look at this and they're like, yeah, but it's, you know, it's only 5 to 7% more and stuff like that. This is the highest of the highest end. You're paying for that extra bit of performance. This is not a value proposition CPU. This is about, you have a massive stack of CPUs already that are great, like the 12400F, 12600, but for that special class of people, that's where this sits, right? This is the king of the fastest gaming processors.
Now, the good thing about, so that's the king, but the good thing about this new whole family is we have this whole stack of processors, right? So we have something for you, regardless of what you consider value, what do you want to do, all the way from Core i3 to the new KS in the family. So it's been pretty exciting.
In fact, I mean, you know, as somebody who does, I mean, this is what we do is we build PCs for a living. We talk to people about specs. I mean, we're building $800 systems with like 12400Fs or 12100s that are using 3050s and 6600s, and these things are killer 1080p machines, even some playing games okay at 1440p, and that used to not be a thing when you think about what it is. So I think it's awesome to see we have that value level, but then all the way up to the KS, which is like we played a 3090 Ti with Cyberpunk 2077 at 140-plus frames per second. We're seeing massive uplift at 1080p with DDR5 and a 12900KS. And again, that's all data. If you're on my Discord, it's all there for you to go look at if you guys want to go see the 45 charts that we have on this thing.
Yeah.
I'm excited for what we're building today.
And, well, that's kind of the reason that we like to have you here, Robbie. Yeah. So you can actually be like a third party to provide all this data so that other people can go look at it. We also have our own data,
but we'd rather have you. But we don't trust you guys.
Yeah, I know. So that's why we have Robbie.
So, Marcus, why don't you take some time? Why don't you introduce us and tell us a little bit more about what's going on with the KS?
Right. Well, like you said, right, there's a whole family of processors, and really right now the 12900KS that we're talking about today is the best example of that. But it shares everything with that whole family, top to bottom. You've got your performance hybrid architecture that's brand new with 12th gen, right? That means you have your performance cores or P cores. You've got your E cores, efficient cores, and these work together seamlessly with Intel ThreadDirector. But we have everything, right? Roby mentioned that there's a 12400F. I think that's, in my opinion, the value king, right? And we also have the performance crown with our 12th gen across the board. And I would call the 12900KS that crown jewel in that performance crown.